Matt Duchesne on Friday, Ryan Dzingel on Saturday. Life can't get any better for me, until of course they trade Stone today.
Not again.
Do you see that long train of cars leaving the Canadian Tire Center? There was the one parade, who were heading to the airport because nobody can leave Ottawa fast enough. And the other set were driving to the cemetery because Ottawa's grave has been dug and their funeral is about to start. It's the end of the Sens as we know it, and I'm not fine. It's time the Sens have a new rule. If you're a star and you play in Ottawa, you're gone immediately. No time for the fans to love the player. No time for the player to have his contract run out. And no time for bad stuff to happen and make them untradeable. They come in, they're good, they get traded, we get the assets, and everyone moves on. But no! We have to bring in this 7th round pick, let him blossom, turn into an offensive talent, and then ship him out. Welcome to life as a Sens fan.
Eventually.
It's nice to finally be back and join the guys, and yeah, it's just good to be back.
Well, well, well. What a difference 2 years makes. Guys are leaving Ottawa with a little less frequency, although two left and only one came back. And that funeral, well, actually, that funeral's still happening because the Sens are still in the toilet. The only difference is, now the team has a bunch of good young players. Then, they just traded all their good players. So yes, almost 2 years to the day after the Sens ship Ryan Dzingel to Columbus, they turn around, phone Don Waddell in Carolina, and acquire Ryan Dzingel for Alex Galchenyuk and Cedric Paquette. How bringing Dzingel back will work? Well, only time will tell. But the thing that I really liked about this trade was the Sens effectively just shuffled around deck chairs. They traded two guys that were basically bit parts in Cedric Paquette and Alex Galchenyuk and brought in a guy like Ryan Dzingel that, well, he hasn't quite been the same offensive player he was when he left Ottawa, should give them a little bit more than what they were getting out of those two guys. Basically, you give up two guys that can't even really make your lineup and bring in one guy who can, and in the process, open up the ability for another young guy to get into the lineup. So from that standpoint, I thought it was an excellent move. But let's be honest for a minute. The Ryan Dzingel the Sens traded away is not even close to the same Ryan Dzingel the Sens are getting back. In fact, I don't expect Ryan Dzingel to even get close to the same opportunities with this Sens team as he did with the other Sens team he was traded from. To be perfectly honest with you, the highest I expect Ryan Dzingel to play in the lineup is third line. I can't see him playing above Brady Tkachuk, and I don't see him playing ahead of Tim Stützle. So what are they actually getting in Ryan Dzingel? Well, in the 57 games before Ryan Dzingel was traded in the 2019 season, he had 22 goals. In the 96 games since he was traded, he has 14 goals and 45 points. Oh, and he has 1 goal and 1 point in 13 playoff games in that span as well. So he had 22 goals in 57 games with the Sens. He has 14 goals in 96 games since. So the Sens trade him as a perennial 20-goal scorer and get him back as a guy who can't even score 10. You know what though? Offensive downturn aside, I actually do like the move, like I said. I think Dzingel can provide this team with some excellent speed, can still pot the odd one or two, and honestly, if Pierre Dorion talked to Dzingel before this deal and made sure that Dzingel's okay with coming back, we don't exactly know what it was like when he left, that will be a huge move for the Sens. If he's not pleased to be back, things could unravel in a hurry. Hopefully he'll be happy to be back, and hopefully he can rediscover that goal-scoring form he had when he left the Sens. I think of all the questions we can ask about Dzingel, the biggest one is going to be, will he be happy to be back in Ottawa? Because like I said, if not, things could get ugly in a hurry, and if they are, maybe all of a sudden he feels rejuvenated and he starts scoring at that quick pace like he used to in Ottawa. On the ice, the biggest thing Dzingel is going to bring for me is speed. This team could use a little more infusion of speed. Not that they're super slow, but they're also far from the quickest teams in the league, and Dzingel's going to help with that. And the best part of all of this, if things don't work out, Dzingel's a UFA at the end of the year, you can cut bait and move on. And if things go perfectly, maybe you rebuild his value and can flip him out at the deadline for extra value. At the end of the day though, I'm just happy to have Dzingel back. I hope he starts tearing it up in Ottawa, signs long term, and can stick around for a while and provide that valuable speed. Because with him and Connor Brown in the lineup now, oh boy, we're going to be seeing a lot of breakaways. Might not be seeing a lot of goals, but we're going to be seeing a lot of breakaways. That's something I'll always remember from his first stint in Ottawa. The number of breakaways that guy got was unbelievable. It's funny, when Dzingel first started breaking out with the Sens, he got breakaways all the time. And I can remember screaming to my buddy all the time about how Dzingel would be a 30 goal scorer if he could just score on some of those breakaways. As his time in Ottawa developed, he started scoring on those goals more and more, and he started wearing on me more and more. Dzingel used to frustrate me, much like Connor Brown does now. I like the player, I like the effort, I love the speed, I like the opportunities they get, but I hate their finishing ability. It feels like neither one of those guys can really finish. Or at least Dzingel couldn't. As he worked his way along in Ottawa, he got better and better at that. In fact, he got so good at it, my one lasting memory from Ryan Dzingel was actually him burying a goal-scoring chance. It's Game 7 of the 2017 Eastern Conference Finals. The Sens are down a goal, and who jams one by Matt Murray to force the game into overtime? None other than Ryan Dzingel. Hopefully, in the not-too-distant future, he's outscoring big playoff goals for the Sens like that once again. I loved watching him play in Ottawa before, and I'm excited to see him back. So welcome back, Ryan Dzingel. So that's it for this video. Hit like if you liked it, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, share it with anybody you know, and let me know down below, what did you think of the Dzingel trade? Did you like it? Didn't you like it? What do you think he can provide with the Sens? Let me know down below, and we'll see you next Saturday after three straight road games against the Leafs.